in the recent history of Chinese art, the story of one particular sculptor stands out. With an artistic career spanning 7 decades, Liu Huangzhang has witnessed many important stages in the evolution of Chinese contemporary art. Our reporter Li Cheng visited his workshop to see how his style has changed over the years. And we can say that he's a broad-minded artist, even at the age of 92. He's not bounded by the impressions of the past, with his latest pieces reflecting the modern society we live in. Let's hear his story.
Stones, hammers, and carving tools. His closest companions for the best part of his life. And at the age of 92, Liu Huangzhang isn't prepared to let them go just yet. Liu Huangzhang's talents and experiences are well known in China. His exhibition, In the World, offers a great opportunity for many to better understand the development of contemporary Chinese art.
像他这一代的这个雕塑家呢，或者说艺术家也好，这艺术生命也是跟这个时代的这个变化也是紧密相关的。
Fond of sculpture since childhood, Liu Huangzhang got a fortunate break early in his career. In the 1950s and 60s, a number of sculpture departments or majors were established in art academies across the country. Liu was invited to enroll, and he earned his position.
在这个学院里的训练，他可以知道前辈的雕塑家。 在这个二三零年代，在欧洲留学的这个接受过现代主义训练的这些雕塑家，是怎么工作的，然后也看到一些其他的这个同行同学是怎么学习和怎么创作的，这个对他来说是非常重要的。In
1959, on the occasion of the 10th anniversary of the founding of the People's Republic of China, the nation's capital, Beijing, saw the building of a number of important structures, including the Great Hall of the People. Another was the Beijing Workers' Stadium. And this features one of Liu's best-known works.
这个是踢足球的两个运动员，这是铲球的，这个是跑着踢的。后来好多人问我，中国。 当时还没这种先进的铲球的东西，他说你从哪儿来？我说我看匈牙利的画报，那个时候，匈牙利画报上看的。As
his reputation grew, Liu Huangzhang started to think about how he could build on his talents. In the early 1960s, he decided to hit the road to find out more about how the ancients practiced sculpture. Liu studied the Buddha statues carved on the rocks hundreds or even thousands of years ago. He found out that the faces of these bodhisattvas were quite distinct. They looked reserved and quiet, with their eyes half open. Soon after that, Liu created one of his masterpieces called Young Lady.
我是从敦煌回来以后，用中国的手法刻的挺纯净的这么一个女性，所以完全用佛像的手法，菩萨低眉，你看眼、嘴，还有都像中国佛像里边的东西。这个是等于是您当时的成名作。对，当时很轰动这些作品。
And his daughter has been quite a frequent model for him.
这个太好了，这。
那这我刻到哪儿，然后他就问我爸，你刻哪儿了？
我说磕眼睛他就眨眼，我说磕嘴他就撅嘴，所以他就不让我好好的磕呀。
这太棒了，这个我真的一看就觉得这特别的灵动，就肯定带着深深的父爱磕的这个作品。
这是小、更小，这个大了以后，
这长大了以后，
他是非常非常细腻和情感丰富的一个人，从他的这些雕塑的作品里也能看得出来，就是他的这些硬纸材料的雕塑，他很多时候故意把一些刀痕和斧痕留下来，其实这些非常细小的手法吧，让他的作品更加生动，更加放松，而这些语言更加丰富了他的这个雕塑本身的一些魅力吧。
The 1980s was an important decade for Chinese artists. Through the government's reform and opening up program, they began to seek change and innovation. It was in those years that Liu Huanzhang moved to an even higher level. Most of his works are relatively small in size, largely because he preferred to work on his own.But also because he only had a bicycle to move his materials.
他作为中年一代的艺术家，他有他的特殊的视野和特殊的经验，所以在他的作品里面，我们可以看到他有既跟传统学习，也有就是纯粹的形式探索。就比如说他雕的这些小型的羊，我们可以看到跟汉代的石刻霍去病墓前面的这些雕塑有关系，我们看上去是立体的雕塑，但事实上它只雕了这个动物的这个两个侧面，更像是一个浮雕的概念。那还有就是说像他做的这些小鹿啊，更多的也是形式的探索，更多几何的方形的这些外轮廓运用在作品里面。
Day after day, one piece at a time. Since he turned 60,If anything, his new pieces seem to be even closer to reality, as if they're learning from the world around him.
我看很多人都看手机在那儿坐着，有的走路也看，所以我就做了一个拿手机在走着看手机的，所以题目就是上班路上。
These works have recorded Liu Huanzhang's observations of the world.And for many, they form an album of the past 7 decades. Li Qiong, CGTN.